There is an understated elegance in Obi-Wan Kenobi's lightsaber technique, one that is quite unlike the feel one might get from the other great swords beings of the Jedi Order. He lacks entirely the flash, the pure bold elan of an Anakin Skywalker. There is nowhere in him the penumbral ferocity of a Mace Windu or a Deepa Bilaba, nor the stylish grace of a Shakti or a Dooku, and he is nothing resembling the whirlwind of destruction that Yoda can become. He is simplicity itself. That is his power. Before Obi-Wan had left Coruscant, Mace Windu had told him of facing Grievous in single combat atop a maglev train during the General's daring raid to capture Palpatine. Mace had told him how the computers, slaved to Grievous's brain, had apparently analyzed even Mace's unconventionally lethal vapad, and had been able to respond in kind after a single exchange.
"He must have been trained by Count Dooku," Mace had said, "so you can expect Makashi as well. Given the number of Jedi he has fought and slain, you must expect that he can attack in any style, or all of them. In fact, Obi-Wan, I believe that of all living Jedi, you have the best chance to defeat him."
This pronouncement had startled Obi-Wan, and he had protested. After all, the only form in which he was truly even proficient was Sarisu, which was the most common lightsaber form in the Jedi Order. Founded upon the basic deflection principles all Padawans were taught, to enable them to protect themselves from blaster bolts, Sarisu was very simple, and so restrained and defense-oriented that it was very nearly downright passive. "But surely, Master Windu," Obi-Wan had said, "you with the power of Vapad, or Yoda's mastery of Ataro." Mace Windu had almost smiled.
"I created Vapad to answer my weakness. It channels my own darkness into a weapon of the light. Master Yoda's Ataro is also an answer to weakness. The limitations of reach and mobility imposed by his stature and his age. But for you, what weakness does Sarisu answer?"
Blinking, Obi-Wan had been forced to admit he'd never actually thought of it that way.
"That is so like you, Master Kenobi," the Corran master had said, shaking his head. "I am called a great swordsman because I invented a lethal style. But who is greater, the creator of a killing form, or the master of the classic form?"
"I'm very flattered that you would consider me a master, but really..."
"Not a master, the master," Mace had said. "Be who you are, and Grievous will never defeat you."
So now, facing the tornado of annihilating energy that is Grievous's attack, Obi-Wan simply is who he is.
"You fool! I've been trained in your Jedi arts by Count Dooku!" "Attack, Kenobi!"
The electro drivers powering Grievous's mechanical arms let each of the four attack thrice in a single second. Integrated by combat algorithms in the BioDroid's electronic network of peripheral processors, each of the 12 strikes per second came from a different angle, with different speed and intensity. An unpredictably broken rhythm of slashes, chops, and stabs, of which every single one could take Obi-Wan's life. Not one touched him. After all, he had often walked unscathed through hornet swarms of blaster fire, defended only by the force's direction of his blade. Countering 12 blows per second was only difficult, not impossible. His blade wove an intricate web of angles and curves, never truly fast, but always just fast enough. Each motion of his lightsaber subtly interfering with 3 or 4 or 8 of the general strikes, the rest sizzling past him, his precise, minimal shifts of weight and stance slipping them by centimeters. Grievous, snarling fury, ramped up the intensity and velocity of his attacks, 16 per second, 18, until finally, at 20 strikes per second, he overloaded Obi-Wan's defense. So Obi-Wan used his defense to attack. A subtle shift in the angle of a single parry brought Obi-Wan's blade in contact not with the blade of the oncoming lightsaber,
but with the hand grip. Slice. The blade winked out of existence a hairbreadth before it would have burned through Obi-Wan's forehead. Half the severed lightsaber skittered away, along with the Duranian thumb and first finger of the hand that had held it. Grievous paused, eyes pulsing wide, then drawing narrow. He lifted his maimed hand and stared at the white-hot stumps that held now only half a useless lightsaber. Obi-Wan smiled at him. Grievous lunged. Obi-Wan parried. Pieces of lightsabers bounced on the durasteel deck. Grievous looked down at the blade-sliced hunks of metal that were all he had left in his hands, then up at Obi-Wan's shining, sky-colored blade, then down at his hands again. And then he seemed to suddenly remember that he had an urgent appointment somewhere else. Anywhere else.